Doug Flynn joins us, certified financial planner, co-founder Flynn Zito Capital Management. It's always good to see you, Doug. I mean, we had a couple of things. I know we had jobless claims that came out today, increased slightly, economic outlook brightening. I saw some of the economic leading indicators, though, with people still arguing, oh, you're not out of the woods in terms of recession. So where are we as we get back into rally mode in the stock market?
Yeah, we had GDP numbers came in. They were a little bit lower than expected, 4.9 instead of 5.2 was the expectation. But that's coming off of 2.1 last quarter, so we would call that a win. You did have jobless claims, which were lower than expected, which is a good thing because that means less people are filing for unemployment. The more important number there is the long-term numbers, and those were flat. So it's kind of mixed, but generally a pretty good backdrop. So I think that sets us up well to roll into 2024.
All right, let's hope. Let me talk to you for a minute about gas prices, because we've seen more and more headlines. It's come up, I think, with this Red Sea story this week, with oil prices, and just in general, people's gas prices started to tick up again. But historically, because it's holiday season, too, everybody's looking at gas prices when they're driving around. Historically, we're pretty good there. Gas prices reaching their lowest level since 2020, and you graph it out. This is okay, right, for the consumer compared to what we were used to paying for gas. That's going back 36 months on this chart.
Sure. Yeah, absolutely. I mean, from the beginning of the year, we're down about 50 cents a gallon. So I think, people saw a 4 cent move up in the last couple of days. So they get a little nervous. But I know that's with what's going on in the Middle East. But, whether or not that's actually a long term trend, it doesn't appear so. You can have these little pops. It seems like next year things might even settle back down a little bit. But generally, the trend has been good there for gas prices, which is following the trend for oil prices. And that's kind of how it goes. There's a little bit of a lag between the oil prices and the gas prices, especially on the way down. On the way up, they raise them right away. On the way down, they take a little bit more time.
Always the case. We all have our own numbers that we look at to see how the economy is doing. I mentioned leading economic indicators a moment ago. The Fed has this thing they call a PCE, price deflator on inflation. They're obsessed with that. Me, I'm different. I, especially this time of year, I look at the Doug Flynn Christmas card index. Now, you mentioned a few weeks ago that you use this. How many Christmas cards you're getting in your house, and it supposedly sends you a message. So we thought we need an update on this, as we get closer. So bring us back to what you were seeing and what you're seeing now. What does it tell you?
So we were behind trend for a while up until last week. I had only gotten 6, and we normally get about 20.
Okay.
And so, but I will say, in the last week, we came on strong and we got into the 20s. I have had people contact me since we did that show and say, listen, Doug, it's nothing personal because,
That's what I suggested. I said, you were starting to say, oh, this is something to do with the economy or people aren't sending out cards. And I said, well, I have my whole wall's full of them at home, so it could be just you. You're saying that there's something in here about the economy.
Yes. And so with coming on strong, I will say we're a little bit lower than what we've been. And I think that just might be a more of a personal situation, although some people have said, they'd rather spend their money on other things and send some e-cards. So I'm trying not to take it so personally, but I will say we did come on strong in the last week.
All right. We'll take it for that it's an economy that's all right. We'll just leave it there. I won't make any more comments about your personal life. Media. We were talking last hour about these rumors that are out there, reports that Paramount, there might be this Warner Brothers merger with Paramount. Those are two huge media companies. So you'd have like the streaming service Max combining with Paramount Plus, and then all these other brands that would potentially combine. According to the reports I've seen, it's very preliminary at this point, but they have spoken. We'll see what happens. Maybe nothing comes of it. But what's your take on this speculation? This would be a very big business story if it actually happened.
Yes. And I think the general backdrop to all of these media and streaming services is what is the long-term outlook, even though there's good cash flow. And this kind of reminds me of, two people that can't swim in the middle of the ocean hanging on to each other. At some point, someone needs to throw them a life preserver. And I think they're all waiting for maybe Comcast or somebody like that to throw them a life preserver.
You mean streaming, right? Is streamers.
In streaming,
right?
Exactly.
Because Netflix makes money. I said this when Colby Hall was a media reporter, was our guest last hour. I said, it's one thing if you're Netflix, but if you, these other, whether it's Max or Paramount Plus, or they're not making money doing it yet.
That's right. And, yeah. and when you play that out, like number crunchers will do, you're saying, what's the game plan here? I mean, you would think they're making money. They have this library and they put it online. Like, what is the real cost? But it's content and the other things to stay relevant and to get people spending another $10 a month for yet another service. So they need a better long-term plan. And I think they've come together to realize that going it alone on these streaming services is not going to cut it. They need to figure something out. And it's part of the bigger play, just keep getting bigger is the way it goes.
But combining these behemoths would make sense. The other question I had, and this would be a better question for you actually, would be about all the debt they would take on. And I was reading today, it would be like 60-some billion dollars in debt. That would be ridiculous amount of debt. It would take you forever to work your way out of that, wouldn't it?
And you've got regulatory issues. You have declining viewership. You have the intense competition. They're still fighting the bigger players. And that heavy debt load, that has to be serviced. And a lot of that debt, by the way, is not necessarily fixed rate debt. So if it's floating, you're going to end up having higher and higher interest rates based on where they initially issued them years ago. So all that has to be baked in as part of the equation of why they've come to realize that they're probably not best to go it alone.
Yeah. And after these negative comments about these big companies, you will not be on the Christmas card list from either Warner Brothers or Paramount. But News Nation will give you one. So thank you, Doug, as always. Doug Flynn on
and
that.
Merry Christmas to you guys.
Merry Christmas to you as well. We appreciate you giving us so much time all year long. You know the.